Hi, I'm doing my first tonight. I'm not gonna wait until tomorrow. This first one's gonna be about this right here. Defend America First. I'm doing the introduction. In the front here, it's got a nice little cartoon that was in the newspaper back then. All right, this little kid, on the back of his pajamas, it says the people. So you can guess how FDR thought of us back then, right? Now, this is the fight against foreign war has just begun. The vote on neutrality revision was the closest on any war legislation yet. There is still time to keep out. If you do your part by joining America First, America First Committee, 52 Devonshire Street, Boston, Capital 4144. Above, a poster from the American First Committee urges Americans to actively protest American imperialist adventures in Europe and across the globe. The picture features President Franklin D. Roosevelt. Roosevelt? Ring any bells? Roosevelt? Yeah. Three-time president, but he's still a Roosevelt? He did a real good job snowing people, didn't he? There's so much garbage out there in the background that most people, even to this day, aren't aware about this guy. How he ever got three times. Thank God for the internet. It ain't gonna help us, but at least we know more. And we ain't gonna take it up the quite so willingly as these unsuspecting people did back then. And we will not be manipulated as much if we empower ourselves with wisdom, which we turn into knowledge by action. Okay? So understand, you gotta understand that perception. You get the knowledge, then you turn it into wisdom by putting it into practice. All right. Anyway, features President Franklin D. Roosevelt reading a bedtime story to a small boy, the American people. The bedtime story is entitled "The Story About the Destruction of Religion Throughout the World." The boy replies, "Gee, that's awful. Now read the one about Uncle Joe killing the 50,000 Christians." Joe Stalin? Joseph Stalin? Get any clue? Okay. All right. Now, this is the introduction itself. It is not likely that you are going to find any of the speeches reproduced in this volume in any of the standard historical works issued for public consumption today. Each of these speeches, delivered on behalf of the nonpartisan America First Committee, contains cognate and indeed prophetic arguments against U.S. intervention in the war in Europe that ultimately evolved into what we now know today as World War II. The arguments put forth in these speeches represented, although one would hardly know it today, the thinking of an overwhelming majority of the American people. See, you forget your history, instigated to think otherwise, okay? Influences even back then. They're still active. That's why some of my videos are being pulled down. Yeah, can't really relate too much information, it seems. So watch while it's still here. That's all I got to tell you. The arguments put forth in these speeches represented, although one would hardly, oh, all right, the eminent statesmen whose addresses are republished here for the first time in 50 years are of a mold that has long ago been broken. Yet, truth be told, one of these men, Senator Lodge, ultimately abandoned his American First nationalism and emerged during the Cold War years as a leading internationalist. You know what happened? Profit. Special interest and plutocratic power brokers prevailed. Although what one historian called the back door to war, the United States entered into the war, and the course of history was forever altered, and perhaps not for the better. The claims of those whom Professor Harry Elmer Barnes contemptuously branded the court historians notwithstanding. Ironically, although so many years have passed and times have changed so drastically, the warnings against the U.S. intervention in foreign conflicts are as prudent today as they were half a century ago. Modern-day politicians, where are the real statesmen? Could learn much by perusing this little volume, The Barnes Review. All right. I still have time. So, this is the principles of the American First Committee. Number one, United States must build an impregnable defense for America. Did you hear that? United States must build an impregnable defense for America. No foreign power nor group of powers can successfully attack a prepared America. 3. American democracy can be preserved only by keeping out of the European war. 4. Aid short of war beyond the limitations of cash and carry weakens national defense at home and threatens to involve America in war abroad. Objectives: nonpartisan. To bring together all Americans, regardless of possible differences on other matters, who see eye to eye on these principles. This does not include fascist nor communist. To urge America to keep their heads and rising hysteria. To urge Americans to keep their heads amid rising hysteria in times of crisis. 3. To provide sane national leadership for the majority of the American people who want to keep out of the European war. 4. To register this opinion with Congress. National Committee: Avery Brundage, Janet Ayer Fairbank, John T. Flynn, Henry Ford, Bishop Wilbur E. Hammaker, General Thomas Hammond, J.C. Hormel, Clay Judson, Catherine Lewis, Alice Roosevelt Longworth, Hanford McNider, Thomas N. McCarter, Ray McCaig, Sterling Morton, Dr. Albert W. Palmer, William H. Regenery, Edward Rickenbacker, Lessing J. Rosenwald, Edward L. Ryerson, Jr., R. Douglas Stewart, Jr., Louis Taber, M. W. Thatcher, Oswald Garrison Villard, Mrs. Burton K. Wheeler, Dr. George H. Whipple, and no, it's not the same guy with the toilet tissue, General Robert E. Wood, and R. Douglas Stewart. These are some of the people who made up this committee, people. And I'm going to be doing the first speech next. I'm just going to title an Introduction to Defend America First. The first speech is given by General U.S. Johnson, and he broadcasted over NBC Network on September 5th, 1940. Now, the reason I'm reading this information, they weren't shooting the bull when they tell you it's hardly possible to get any of this information. So I want you to listen to this with a clarity of mind. Get in a clear spot. Don't get pressured in any way. And just change some of the names of the players in the game, and everything still applies today. Am I getting through to you? Everything still applies. You just change the names a little bit. Because this is the same game plan they've been on all along that's been working so successfully. This is why I'm doing this series, to give you an insight into where we need to be as a nation, as a people. I already feel that it's gone too far. And I also feel that these people talking about a second American Revolution, it's not a possible, feasible option, because I'll tell you why. Most of the people, the majority of the Americans, are just going to be all too happy to just roll over and say, okay, do it. Just make us safe. Nobody is willing to sacrifice anything as long as they can retain some level of comfort in their materialistic world. Do we have people who will fight and defend and die for principles such as honor, duty, integrity, truth, justice? Yes, there are still some of us out there, but we're very rare. But, hey, I'm going to do what I can, and we'll see what happens, all right? Now, together, I'm offering to share knowledge. I'll publish the names of the people in a document also, so you'll have reference for who these people are. You can look them up, verify this for yourselves, that they were real people. All right, so ends the introduction.